Welcome everyone for a quick PS3 update. As we need to have this install USB stick bootable for people to download, I made your first boot test. Obviously, this PowerPC builds usually boot in IBM and Apple systems, and I will for first step rely that people already have this Petit Boot installed. That is what you usually got 5 years or 10 years or whenever ago with also custom firmware anyway. And I made a first test here. I put here just some kboot file on there. Petit Boot also has a yaboot parser, but in T2 we just migrated from the vintage yaboot to the modern and more universal grub2. While in previous times this yaboot would have worked, now I put there a kboot conf for Petit Boot, and that is this install thing there. And I will probably update the ISO with a config file with SR0 for SCSI CD-ROM0. Actually, this is slightly stupid. I'm not sure if Petit Boot has some automatics for this, but it should because it knows very well which device it mounted to. By the way, did I try leaving this empty? But then I need to reboot anyway. But there are still some more things. So I will probably change this to SR0 if I don't figure out how to auto-detect this with Petit Boot. But if you have some USB stick, for me, this is right now SDD1. I know that a slightly advanced user uncomfortable, but we will see SDD1. The next complication, so this should boot, yeah, booting. So mind you, this is a completely from scratch cross-compiled T2 from the other day. So everything automated, everything completely clean, vanilla source, most minimal P3 patches, everything state-of-the-art and awesome, latest GCC, glibc and Linux kernel and everything. The only complication is that we have so little RAM and we need to load the rest of the installer. Here is our normal second or small second stage. The problem with this is even our second stage in the meantime is too big for just 256 megabytes of memory, and the small one is barely tested and it's not so feature rich. So we need to do something with this. I wanted to refactor this anyway, actually original UDEV in there. So while we get something, it is not the most awesome. Do we even get stone here? We get some extremely simple text stone. This is of course ridiculous. So I have published this ISO already, but as it is right now, it will only boot on Apple and IBM PowerPC, 64-bit anyway. And until this video goes live later today or tomorrow or something, I will have likely updated this ISO with this kboot file for booting on PS3. But this will not yet be awesome. This will only for experts who definitely want to try around with this today or tomorrow or something. I still have to do some tinkering there to optimize memory use and make this super easy for everyone to just install. I'm not sure if this will be possible for me in the next week, but I want to have at least something published, especially for all the Apple and IBM P-series and whatsoever latest PowerPC stuff. For anyway, as I like release often and early, and I should do that more often with T2 as well. I hope you enjoy regular updates and learn something, and don't forget to share, like and subscribe, and I hope to see you soon for the next tinkering to come. Small update, I already tried here this configuration, and indeed if I leave there this one value empty, by the way you can access this to the shell, and that is in var petit boot mnt, here are all the mount points, and this is SDD1. And the kboot file is here, and as you can see we simply don't have a column separator there. You can also edit this mount or remount, read write this, and then vi kboot, and here was previously as per the main page or whatever dev p3 something blah 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 colon. So if we don't have this colon separator there, then Petit Boot apparently, at least for me, this version here, inserts the correct path. That is awesome. So then we can just leave it like this. Remount, read only, run Petit Boot again. And actually quite nice. I'm surprised if you take it out, it removes this entry. And if you plug it in, it inserts this entry at runtime. That is actually pretty neat. Did not expect this. I think it's using UDEV actions there. And so here's install var petit mnt sdd1. I think this should be correct. It's inserting here, unfortunately, this root thing, but I think our installer should probably ignore this anyway. Then I will also change the T2 ISO generation for PowerPC to always include this kboot file. Yeah, that works. Then all our release ISOs always have the kboot file for people who just want to boot T2 install media from existing Petit Boot. And that is pretty awesome. I hope you enjoyed this. So that's it for today. I have these things to clean up and publish. And I hope you tune back in soon.